Children, today we will be starting the chapter 6, Maths Magic, the Junk Seller. So this chapter is all about the mathematics, multiplication and adding the different numbers and how to count the money and what are the money denomination or rupees denomination in our country, that is India. So why the name Junk Seller? Because in this chapter we will be getting inspired from a lady who is working as a junk seller. In Hindi we call her as kabadi wali. Okay, what the junk seller do? Junk seller buys the old or recyclable material, suppose that rubber tires, newspaper, cardboard, plastic bottles, such that. So in this chapter the main focus will be on the multiplication of different numbers, adding of different numbers, and how to calculate the money. Suppose I gave you 1 rupee for one day. So how many rupees you will be getting for 30 days? So these kind of a question we will doing. Okay, so let's see, starting with this. As you can see in the picture, the left hand picture, you can see Kiran Sumitra Kabadi ki dukan. So in Hindi the junk seller means kabadi wala ya kabadi wali. So on right side you can see there are lady sitting and she is working as a junk seller. So have you ever met a kabadi wali, a woman who sells junk? So generally she takes the old material which can be recycled and be sell to the different factories, companies or the person who wants to need that. This is a true story told by Kiran, who has a junk shop in Patna. So this is a shop in Patna. Patna is the capital of Bihar. Now she is telling her story. Her name is Kiran. I studied in Hindi medium school in my village. My father wanted girls to study like boys. I loved Hindi and science, but I hated maths. Today math is most useful for my work. I could never imagine this in school. So she is doing a work as kabadi wali or the junk seller, where she has to calculate the money, add the money or subtract the money. So she should be having a good quality of maths on the tips. Otherwise what will happen? She will not able to gain the profits. So maths is very very beneficial for her. So now see, what about you? So these are the question. What about you that you find difficult math? Difficult math is the very easiest and most scoring subject. If you understand the concept properly, you can get out of out marks in the maths. So what is the most difficult thing in your maths book, and what do you think the easiest lesson? So this vary from other children to children. Some children find some topic very difficult, other children find that topic very easy. So we'll not talk about that. When I was young, my father died in accident. So my mother worked as a servant in some houses. We had difficult time. I have to leave school after class 8. I wanted to study more, but my mother got me married. So she got married very early. So now my husband's family lived in a mud house. His two brothers and sister did not go to school. He had a tea stall. So where the Kiran got married, the husband lives in a mud house with two brothers and sister, and he had a tea stall as a working. So now based on this is a little, we are taking the help of story because we will be doing questions like this and we will be doing multiplication. So more multiplication, you should be knowing the table from 2 to 20. If you know the table from 2 to 20, it would be very easier for how to calculations can be done very fast. And I would recommend that you should write the table from 2 to 20 in any kind of a rough notebook, so that it will be very helpful to you to learn the table. So suppose now question, depending on situation, find out how much for a cup of tea. So her husband is selling the tea at a tea stall. Suppose if you are having a tea at tea stall, small shop which is on the side of road. So generally we give 5 rupees for small cup or 10 rupees for big cup. But at a hotel when we go, sometimes the tea, cup of tea would be 50 rupees. In big hotels it is 500 rupees also, 100 rupees, that much. If now based on this situation, in the cloud, see the Ghibli is there. If a person who runs a tea stall earns rupees 30 in a day, how much will he earn in 10 days and in a month, and how did you get the answer, discuss. So we will be taking this question only, we'll be solving with the help of whiteboard. Now I'll come to that portion. So they are saying a person who runs tea stall earns rupees 30 in a day. How much we will earn in 10 days and in a month? So in a month, how many days are there? 30 days. So we will be calculating for the month also. So how we'll do? We have to write all things. Suppose how much rupees he is getting? He is getting rupees 30. We'll write the price of tea by selling in one day. So price of tea by selling in one day. So he is selling tea only and he is earning rupees 30. So similarly for 10 days, how many? Similarly, price of tea by selling in how much days? We have to calculate 10 days. So what we'll do? Rupees 30 will come as it is, and here 10 days, so we'll take 10 here into 10. So the answer will be how much? 30 into 10, 0, 0, 0, 3 is a 0, 1, 0 is a 0, 1, 3 is a 3. Answer will be 0 and 3. So the answer will be rupees 300. Now this is for the 10 days. Price of tea by selling in a month. In a month, how many days? 30 days. So again, for one day it was rupees 30. So we will bring rupees 30 only, and we will multiply this by 30. So again, 30 into 30. 0, 0, 0, 3 is a 0, 0, 3, 3 is a 9. By adding, we will get 0, 0, and 9. So he is getting rupees 900. Okay, so this is the for 1 month. Now, coming back to the textbook again. So how did we get the answer? How did you get the answer? We get the answer by multiplying. Okay. In a different way, I'll tell you how we do the multiplication. Very easy. Suppose, let's take example. This is mango. One mango is of 5 rupees. This is the new symbol for rupees when we are writing. So suppose one mango is for 5 rupees. How much we have to pay for 10 mangoes? How much we have to pay for 10 mangoes? सो एक मैंगो का प्राइस कितना? रुपीज़ 5. 10 मैंगोज का देना है. सो आइदर वी कैन डू 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5 + 5. आइदर वी कैन डू दैट वी कैन ऐड 5 10 टाइम्स. ओके, हाउ? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, but this process will take long. So, what we'll do? We'll do the easier one. We will do 5 into 10. So, 5 tens are 50. Iska answer bhi kitna aayega? 50. Now, which method is the easiest one? This one. Okay, here we are doing the calculation very easy. We know the table because here the digit is 5. We can add, it will take long time. So to make it shorter and to make the calculation very fast, we use multiplication. Okay, now moving to the textbook again. Now Kiran is saying that I thought of starting my own business. I thought I would open a bangle shop or a tailor shop. So when she got married, she started thinking that she will open a bangle shop or other different type of another shop so that she can also help the family in earning the money. But my uncle said we could earn lot by opening a junk shop. In 2001, my mother-in-law and I opened a junk shop. We took a loan of 8,000 for the shop. So what is the loan, first of all? We'll understand what is a loan. Loan. Loan is a word which is used to describe the amount of money given from one person to another. Suppose this is Mohan. Mohan is very rich. And this is Sohan. And he is poor. Now, Sohan wants to open a shop, but he don't have any money. So what he will do, he will borrow money from Mohan. So Mohan is very rich, so he can give the money easily to Sohan, and Sohan wants to borrow money to open a shop. So this is what he is doing. Sohan is taking loan. Okay, Sohan is taking loan from Mohan. So this is called loan. So here we have taken example of two persons, but most of the time generally the loan is given, can be given by person, bank, private companies, okay, and it can be friend can also give loan, relative. So why do we call it loan? Again, try to understand. Suppose two people are there. Sohan and Mohan. Suppose Sohan needs ₹100. So he goes to Mohan that, Mohan, you please give me ₹100, I want. Sohan said, I will give you ₹100. Okay, but when you have to give me the more money in return. So he is asking more money, you give me ₹10 over ₹100. So it means he is giving ₹100, but in return Sohan have to pay ₹110 in back. It means usne 100 rupees ke upar 10 rupees extra de raha hai. So why Mohan is asking for 10 rupees extra? So when we are giving loan, we want something in return, hai na, jab hi to hamara benefit hoga, then bank is giving loan. So that extra money is interest, use interest bolte hain. Okay, suppose bank ne loan diya, mujhe loan diya, I want to buy a car 5 lakh rupees ka. I want a car, I want to take a bank loan of 5 lakh rupees, but abhi maine gaadi bhi le liya. Okay, I have purchased a car. Now I have started giving back the amount. So slowly every month I am paying ₹50,000. I am paying ₹50,000 every month to the bank. Main bank ko wapis de raha hu. So for how many months I am giving the, for how many months? How will know? We will divide 5 lakh by 50,000. So 4 0 says 0. For 10 months आई हैव टू पे 50,000, बट हियर डिफरेंट थिंग इज दैट आई हैव टू पे 5 लाख रुपीज प्लस इंटरेस्ट, बिकॉज बैंक विल बी ऑल्सो अर्निंग अ मनी ओवर दिस. सो दिस हाउ द थिंग्स वर्क. मतलब हमने क्या किया, बैंक से पैसा लिया और क्या फ्रेंड से पैसा लिया. सो वी आर गिविंग बैक द सेम अमाउंट विद एक्स्ट्रा मनी. सो एवर यू हैव यू एवर हर्ड समवन टेकिंग अ लोन? सो व्हेन वी हैव टू मेक द हाउस, व्हेन वी टेक हाउस लोन और होम लोन, वी हैव टू बाय द कार, दैट टाइम ऑल्सो वी हैव टू बाय द कार लोन. सपोज सम थिंग्स नीडेड मनी इन आर हाउस, सो एट दैट टाइम वी नीड वट पर्सनल लोन. सो हाउ मच लोन वॉज टेकन, हाउ मच मनी वॉज पेड बैक. नो नाउ अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज देयर, एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन, हरी एंड बाबू वॉन्ट टू बाय अ हैंड कार्ड फॉर ₹300. हैंड कार्ड इज ओके. सो नाउ हरी इज सेइंग, आई हैव टेकन अ लोन ऑफ ₹300 फ्रॉम अ बैंक फॉर 6 मंथ्स. आई विल पे ₹51 एवरी मंथ टू द बैंक. एंड बाबू इज सेइंग, बाबू बट आई हैव टेकन अ लोन ऑफ 300 फ्रॉम चुन्नीला, आफ्टर 6 मंथ्स आई हैव टू पे ₹360. सो हियर डिफरेंट थिंग अगेन वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट. सी हाउ हरिया एंड बाबू. नाउ हरिया इज सेइंग यस, बोथ हैव टेकन द लोन ऑफ ₹300. नाउ हरिया इज सेइंग ही विल बी पेइंग ₹50 फॉर 6 मंथ्स. सो 6 से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, आंसर क्या होगा? 6 1 6, 6 5 30. सो ही विल बी पेइंग फॉर 6 मंथ्स ₹306. नाउ बाबू हैव ऑल्सो हैव टेकन ₹300, बट ही हैज़ टेकन फ्रॉम चुन्नी लाल फ्रॉम अ पर्सन एंड ही सेइंग दैट आई विल बी पेइंग ₹360. सो हाउ मैनी मच मोर ही इज पेइंग, ही इज पेइंग क्या करेंगे, जितना लिया था उसको माइनस करेंगे, 0 माइनस 0, 6 माइनस 0 इज 6. सो बाबू इज पेइंग ₹60 एक्स्ट्रा एंड हियर हरिया इज पेइंग ओनली ₹6 एक्स्ट्रा. सो हु इज पेइंग मोर इंटरेस्ट? बाबू इज पेइंग मोर. नाउ वट इज हैपनिंग हियर, हियर हरिया इज टेकन लोन फ्रॉम बैंक एंड बाबू हैज टेकन लोन फ्रॉम चुन्नी लाल. सो चुन्नी लाल इज अ पर्सन, ही बैंक इज अ अथॉरिटी विच कैलकुलेट द इंटरेस्ट विच इज टोल्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट, बट चुन्नी लाल इज अ पर्सन, ही कैन डू वट एवर ही वॉन्ट्स. अगर उसको ₹60 चाहिए, मतलब ईच मंथ ही इज पेइंग ₹10 एक्स्ट्रा, ही कैन आस्क फॉर ₹20 पर मंथ ऑल्सो. सो दैट्स वाई वेन वी आर टेकिंग लोन और वी आर बोरोइंग मनी फ्रॉम बैंक, इट इज़ वेरी वेरी चीपर इन कंपेयर इफ वी आर कैरिंग द लोन फ्रॉम प्राइवेट कंपनी और इंडिविजुअल. इंडिविजुअल मीन्स एनी पर्सन, मेल फीमेल और एनी फ्रेंड. ओके, इन अ ईजी वे वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड. सपोज अगेन विल टेक 2 एग्जाम्पल्स हियर, सीता गीता. नाउ गीता बोरोड 10 टॉफीज. ओके, 10 टॉफीज फ्रॉम सीता. सीता सेड आई विल गिव यू 10 टॉफीज दिस वीक. ओके, बट इन रिटर्न यू हैव टू गिव मी बैक 12 टॉफीज नेक्स्ट वीक. गीता ने इस हफ्ते कितना टॉफीज लिया सीता से? 10. बट सीता ने कहा आई विल गिव यू 10 टॉफीज ओनली व्हेन यू विल गिव मी 12 टॉफीज नेक्स्ट वीक. इट मीन्स शी इज टेकिंग मोर इन रिटर्न. ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड इंटरेस्ट. नाउ सो क्वेश्चन इज दैट हु हैज़ टू पे बैक मोर, हरिया और बाबू. सो वी ऑलरेडी नो, वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड दैट Babu is paying more. Now come to the currency part. We'll be showing the different images. As you can see on the screen, right now in India, currently we are using the coins in form of rupee 1, rupee 2, rupee 5 and rupee 10. Okay, so these are the images. Rupee 50 paisa we are not using right now. So it is been stopped by the government of India. So here are the images. Okay, now note, how many kinds of note? So this is the 2000 rupee note, as you can see on the screen. If you watch it carefully, you can see the picture of Mangalyaan on the back side of the 2000 rupees note. Okay, then coming back to the 500 rupees note, if we'll see properly, you are able to see the picture of Red Fort on the 500 rupees note. And 200 rupees note, you can see the picture of Sanchi Stupa. This Sanchi Stupa is in state of Bihar. Okay, and the color of the note is a little bit yellowish and orange. Now 100 rupees new note, Rani Ki Vav. Okay, it is a kind of a place where the water is reserved for the drinking or any kind of a usage. After coming this, we have the 50 rupee notes. Very familiar picture, you can identify easily. This is the picture we have taken from Hampi. Okay, 50 rupees note, blue color. Then we have 20 rupees note. This is the picture of taken from Ellora Caves. Okay, now come to the 10 rupees note. We have the picture of Sun Temple. Sun Temple, which is in Odisha. Okay, Mahatma Gandhi is placed on. Okay, so these are the notes which we use in the Indian country as to pay something or to buy something. So before understanding this and moving on, we'll understand. In rupee 1 is equal to 100 paisa, rupee 5 is equal to 500 paisa. क्या किया हमने यहाँ पे, वी आर मल्टीप्लाई 5 ऑन बोथ साइड. रुपी 10 कितना होगा, मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे 10 इंटू 100, विल गेट 1000 पैसा. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज रुपीज 20, अगेन विल मल्टीप्लाई विद 100, देन इट विल बी 2000 पैसा. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन, सपोज आई हैव 500 रुपीज नोट प्लस 200 रुपीज नोट, सो हाउ मच मनी आई हैव, रुपीज 700. सपोज आई हैव 2000 रुपी नोट प्लस रुपीज 500, सो आई हैव हाउ मच मनी, रुपीज 2500. Suppose I have rupees 20 plus rupees 10. 20 plus 10 is rupees 30. Now we have added the amount which is given in one or two digits. Suppose what happened, I have 2000 rupees. I have the note of 2000 rupees and I have many, many notes. Okay, suppose I counted the notes were 20 notes I have of rupees 2000. Now, if I have to calculate that how much total money is that, otherwise I have to add 2000 plus 2000 plus 2000 like this. So, it will go very long. So, we will not use this method. Okay, what we'll do? We will multiply 2000 into 20, 0, 0, 0, 0 to the 0. Next, 2, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 2 to the 4. 0, 0, 0, 0, here 4. So, how much rupees is 4? Uske aage kitna 0 hai? 4. So, we have 40,000 rupees. This is how we have to do. So, first of all, you have to learn tables 2 to 20, then only you can do this chapter very easily. So we will be doing all other questions and activities in the next session. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.